Lord, I lift my hands, I give all the praise to you. Everything I am, you gave me the strength to do. Lord, I lift my hands,
Lord, I lift my hands,
I give all the praise to you. This is my response for making me brand new.
Hey, Lord, I can feel your presence, putting all your peace in me. Lord, I can feel revival, breaking all the captives free. And though it sounds crazy, man, I used to hate me, till I met somebody who told me how he made me, how he died to save me. And if you want the same thing, all you gotta do is just say,
Lord, I lift my hands, I give all the praise to you.
Yeah, yeah,
everything I am,
everything I am,
you gave me the strength to do.
Yeah, you do.
Lord, I lift my hands,
Lord, I lift my hands,
I give all the praise to you.
I give all the praise.
This is my response for making me brand new.
And I can't help it, I'm just being real. I just walk up to the mic and tell y'all how I feel. Y'all think I'm religious, I'm just tryna eat a meal. But I don't live on bread alone, you hear it in my zeal. Down bad, but you got me better. G-O-D, that's the best three letters. Where you got me moving, I'ma need Rosetta. Keep your head up.
And Lord, I lift my hands, I give all the praise to you. Everything I am, you gave me the strength to do. Lord, I lift my hands, I give all the praise to you. This is my response. Oh, this is my response. This is my response for making me brand new.
Stains have been made new, all just because you wanted to open the gates and flood this room. Not even hell can hide from you. I feel the colors start to
need a rose, but I might push a phantom that's right off the lot. I know I'm serving the father of time, and that's whether I got on a paddock or not. Canada goose for the cold, and they told me to count on my blessings. I counted a lot, stashing my treasure in heaven, where it'll get better and don't gotta weather the ride.
KD the second, that's rapper, that's reverend. They started with Jesus, but I never left it. Think they protected, we tear down your hedges. I gave you the book, but you boys never read it. Don't need your credit, you cannot check on my dress. It's still swinging, I'm Eddie from Tekken. Come to the message, I keep it consecutive.
Hold up, look, Damian Lillard for three. If they pass it to me, I turn you to a meme. I ain't worried about demons. You think the vaccine is the mark of the beast? Need to turn off your screen and get back to the reading and back to some reason. Remember, you giving the flag your allegiance. We lack an agreement. Long as we kids of the king, we still gonna be laughing with Jesus.
No capping or scheming, I'm happily beaming. You have to believe it, I'm tapped in and we got the vision. People don't care, you keep Christ in your Christmas. If they cannot see that there's Christ in the Christian. You do the division, now give me some difference. The spirit of trolling is great, so I give them Paul, no Logan's a James. They weather the storm, but my hands will be brave.
So I don't need a rose, but I might push a phantom that's right off the lot. I know I'm serving the father of time, and that's whether I got on a
paddock or not. Native supply for the drip and Elon for the whip, but I've counted a little, a lot. Placing my treasure in heaven where it'll get better and
don't gotta weather the ride. Yeah, pledge my allegiance, I'm reading Ephesians. I grew with the heathens, I ran with hyenas. They taught me to beat it, that led me to Jesus, he led me to freedom.
The tribe undefeated, we keep it in season. Look, you gotta see it, the home of the free has got 10,000 reasons. No people for pleasing, no fraud in the treason. We really believe this point. 5 on the dot, yeah, yeah. I'm going off and I don't plan to stop. KB and Dilly, yeah, yeah. How y'all is free with a head full of locks? I bring his will to the table. I'm never entangled, I'm giving you red table talk.
Yeah, KB and Dilly, we setting it off.
Do the most, but I do a lot. I'ma make a toast, cause we still alive. No big, I feel like Pac. I shoot a shot. I'm coming in hot. Well, I got the steamer. I bring the fire, but you never seen her. I testify, I don't need a subpoena. They want my soul, better go to Korea. I love my dog just like I'm Peter. Gotta protect him. I made the call, it but just like I'm reffing. I know we left, yeah, now we back together. But I guess that is better now, later than never. Like, what's happening? I'ma need y'all, quit asking when. Me and my wife gonna have some kids. Right now, we just practicing. Practicing. Teacher said, quit rapping, man. That gonna hurt my average. I said, thank God I ain't average. Yeah, I'm a bright young man. Kill the GPA, and the BPM. Look, we on. So say what you say, cause that's A with Lecrae. From the A train to the A, I'm coming in hot. I don't do the most, but I do a lot. I'ma make a toast, cause we still alive. No big, I feel like Pac. I shoot the shot. I'm coming in hot.
Wake him up. See, I'm still sleeping, so I had to shake him up. I kept it too real. Yeah. I wasn't faking up. No. My real life was a headline. Your real life got a deadline. My timeline was a hashtag. Your timeline just a hate crime. Coming in hot, feeling like Pop. Back in I-4 when he took 5 shots. Too much drive to ride your wave. Ditch my top, then I'm off that lot. Black on black on black on black on black on black on black. You don't have to ball a rap to get them racks on racks. Uber poolers trying to catch my vibe and find my way. Yeah, I know I'm ratchet, but I'm really safe. Hot sauce dripping. Everybody wanna start dipping. First nobody wanna listen. Now everybody pay attention. Now everybody pay fee. Even Trump gotta take a knee. When the horn blow, y'all gonna see. Make the wall fall down like
yee. Siggy Middle School, how we doing? What's up, guys? Welcome to Siggy. We're glad you're here. Hey, real quick, I want to give you guys a couple of awesome announcements of some exciting things that are coming up, okay? So, I know spooky season's coming up, am I right? You know what I'm talking about? Yeah. Well, you know, every year, we like to celebrate Halloween as a Siggy family. And so this year, we're having a Siggy Halloween, but we have this kind of dilemma. We had two separate themes that we couldn't decide on, so we decided to go with both. And so here's kind of what we're rocking with. Barbie Top Gun. Gentlemen, the Top Gun's for you. Or Barbie, as someone would say. But hey, here's the deal. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be fun. We want you to invite your friends, whether they come to Siggy or not, at the end of the year, Halloween party. You go Barbie, you can go Top Gun, you can go Army Barbie. It's up to you. We'll let you decide. But hey, we'll tell you more as that date approaches. Hey, and real quick, the next thing. You're not going to want to miss this, I promise. Real quick. Okay. So, not this upcoming Wednesday, but the following Wednesday, we're going to do this thing called Fields of Faith. All right? And if you've never been to Fields of Faith, it's a really awesome event where we get to gather with all the other youth ministries in town, and we get to go to Memorial Stadium, that's the Midland High football stadium, and we get to hear the gospel preach, we get to tailgate, we get to play games, and we also get to see people's lives changed by Jesus. And so, hey, we want to invite you to that. That's at Memorial Stadium, not this Wednesday, but the following Wednesday at 7 o'clock. We're going to have a tailgate. We're going to have games. It's going to be a lot of fun. Be looking out for us on social media, at Siggy Midland. We'll be posting more details coming soon. Well, hey, one more question. Who's ready to worship? Who's ready to worship? Let me hear you. Come on. On your feet. Let's go.
Well, hey, everybody. How we doing? We good? Awesome. Hey, my name is Keith. I have Jesse and Emily with me. Everybody give it up for Emily. Everybody give it up for Jesse. All right, cool. Let's sing. So praise God. We just sang about the goodness, what he does for us. Now we're going to sing about the power that's found in his name. And so would you bow your heads with me? Lord, God, we're so grateful, God, that we get to come into this place, God. We get to come into your house, God, and we get to lift your name on high. God, that name is power and strength and honor. Father, we love you and we thank you. Let's sing. All power and dominion, honor and strength, all wisdom, glory, and thanks. All worship and wonder, unrivaled acclaim, all reverence, all favor, all fame. Come on, let's sing. There's no name. 'Cause there's no name like your name, like your name, Jesus. And all the high praise to no name but your name, Jesus. Oh,
Yeah. praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah. Death has lost its grip on me, 'cause you have broken every chain, and there's salvation in your name. Jesus Christ is my living hope.
Let's sing this one more time.
And hallelujah, praise the one who set me free. Hallelujah, death has lost its grip on me. You have broken every chain. There's salvation in your name. Jesus Christ is my living hope. 'Cause Jesus Christ, you're my living hope.
And Jesus Christ is my living hope. So Father, we thank you for that truth, God, of who you are, God, and what you've done. God, on the power that's found in you. God, we're just so grateful, God. As Jacob's about to come out and speak on Daniel 3, God, we're just reminded tonight, God, that there is not a place that we'll go, God, that you've not been before us. God, you're always with us. In the deepest, darkest of pits, God, you were there. Father, and we thank you when we worship you for that truth, God. So we love you. It's in your Son, Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You guys can be seated.
Kaden, you're so funny.
Kaden, stop. Like, you're literally so funny. Stop.
Jaden might be funny, but there's no purpling at Siggy.
Good job, gang.
Okay, if you will all turn to 2 Kings chapter 2 with me, we're going to read verse 23.
From there, Elijah went up to Bethel. As he was walking up the path, some small boys came out of the city and jeered at him.
We're glad you're here at Siggy, but this is not your living room.
We love that y'all are enthusiastic, but let's worship respectfully.
Wilderness. He was trying to lead these Israelites, and they were just not paying attention to him. Guys, when somebody on stage is talking, make sure you're paying attention to what they're saying.
Oh, come to the altar.
Bruh. It's super distracting when you leave in the middle of worship or when somebody's teaching, so go before the show.
Today is the last day to sign up for Fall Retreat. Mm-hmm.
Guys, we love that y'all are here, but keep the horse playing outside and not in the service.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen!
Guys, don't go out of your way to be the center of attention.
We're so glad y'all came today, and we look forward to seeing you next week.
I love you!
He's so cool.
No one says that. What book are we in?
Guys, it's super distracting to fight while we're in
the middle. I think Jesus. You're doing it wrong.
But girls sit with girls at Siggy's. And guys, you
is
funny. But purpling is unacceptable at Siggy.
Oh.
And we're gonna read.
Action.
We're not ready. In it, please. Hold on.
If you're not pink, you stink.
What an amazing thing. First off, I think some of the seniors that actually made the video are in here, so we'd just love to give them a round of applause for that. But guys, most importantly, like that video said, This is a time where we get to just come and just be with Jesus and be with God and just be, and just having a respect for yourself and your neighbor. That's just the most important thing. But other than that, let's get started for today. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Jacob. I have the honor and privilege of being the intern here at Siggy. But just ultimately, that's just the most exciting thing. But last week, you see, Chase was talking about and walking us through the series called Babylon, where Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego ultimately had a God-sized leadership, where there was God-sized conviction, God-sized confidence, and a God-sized conviction. But ultimately, as he was going through that, I just began to think of why. Why was it so important for them to follow their faith, to have this faith that they have, that they lived? Why is it so important for them to just follow God and be willing to sacrifice their own life for a God that they are? And, you know, it got to thinking of, like, why do I follow God? And, you know, personally, it's simple. Because where I was at before versus where I'm at now is a complete 180. And where I was at before, guys, was a guy that was full of anxiety, full of these thoughts of just not being able to control things. I wanted to control every aspect of my life. And that even came into my friendships and the fact that they needed me to be this amazing guy, that they needed me in order for them to be amazing themselves, that this thing, and it just kept eating me up. I just was trying to control everything in my life. And even in those times where I couldn't, it created this sense of not being able to live up to that standard of being needed. And guys, let me tell you, that anxiety was not fun. There were nights where I wouldn't go to bed. I would sit there for hours and hours trying to go to bed, but it just kept going. My mind just kept racing. I would create false realities and false thoughts to try to soothe myself. And sometimes, guys, to be honest, the only thing that would help me out was by throwing up, because it was the only thing that I could control. It was the only thing where I felt like I had this control and this release to it. And, like, that's the most important thing. But there was one night, I went and I was done. I had all this anxiety, and I was like, you know what, God? I can't handle this anymore. I can't do this. This is unhealthy. There is no sustaining this. Because you see, those people feeling like this sense of want and need couldn't fill a God-sized hole that I had. But God did. God filled that hole. And now I have the honor and privilege of standing here on this stage, getting to teach y'all and get to talk about my faith. And why is it so important for me to have a faith that I'm willing to die and willing to go on a stage that it's not very comfortable, even though I'm the biggest extrovert, that it's the things. And guys, when I tell you your faith is the most important thing, it's real, and you'll see tonight. So I really want to get things started as we dive into this story of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. I want y'all to turn to Daniel, the book of Daniel, to chapter 3. And as we go, I kind of want to set the scene up a little bit for y'all. So we've been going through this thing with Babylon where Daniel, Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego have gotten taken away from their home and have been forced to kind of conform to the life. But you see, so this is where we'll pick up. King Nebuchadnezzar had constructed an image of himself that was made of gold, that was 60 cubits high and 6 cubits wide. Guys, I might be a big guy, but the statue was not me. As you can see behind me, this thing was huge. It could be seen for miles. That's what he wanted. King Nebuchadnezzar wanted people to bow down to him as he was God. And so you see, he built this on the plains of Dura in Babylon. So then he ordered all the important leaders, everybody that was anybody, had to be there, had to witness and bow down to this guy called King Nebuchadnezzar. And so at the dedication ceremony of the golden statue, it was commanded that as soon as you heard the horn, the flute, the harp, pipe, and all kinds of music, everyone must fall down to their knees and worship the image of the golden statue that the king had set up. However, if there was anyone who does not follow those commands, once the music began to be played and was commanded, these people would bow down and say things like, King Nebuchadnezzar, you're the greatest. Our king must live forever. All hail the mighty king. That was to King Nebuchadnezzar. Isn't that crazy? So, as we get to see However, there was anyone who does not follow this command to fall down and worship will immediately be thrown into a blazing furnace. The music began to be played, and as commanded, everyone began to fall down and worship the statue, saying things like, "May the king live forever." But in this huge crowd, there was three people that refused to bow and worship this gold statue. King Nebuchadnezzar heard that there were the three guys that absolutely refused to worship the statue, and he created. And this is where we'll pick up. So everybody turn to verse 13, and we'll start from there. Chapter 3, verse 13, guys. Sorry. Furious with rage, Nebuchadnezzar summoned Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego so that these men were brought before the king, and Nebuchadnezzar said to them, "Is it true, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that you do not serve my gods or worship the image of gold I have set up? Now when you hear the sound of the horn, flute, lyre, harp, pipe, and all kinds of music, if you are ready to fall down and worship the image I made, very good. But if you do not worship it, you will be thrown immediately into the blazing furnace. Then what god will be able to rescue you from my hand?" I'm going to pause for a moment and ask you, guys, what do you idol? What do you bow down to at the moment of the sound of the horn or the harp or the flute? I know for me, I used to idolize this generalization of being perfect. I was chasing perfection. And anytime I wasn't able to be perfect, the sound of the flute was the sense of that I was a failure, that I couldn't be this perfect person. And you know, that's okay because we're not called to be perfect. Jesus is perfect. We're not. And you see, when we're bowing down, when that music plays, that means we're bowing down to what the enemy wants. Because when we bow down, that brings us farther from God. That brings us to a place where we're not idling Jesus, but we're idling God, or idling our enemy. So let's pick back up in 16. So Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego replied to him, "King Nebuchadnezzar, we do not need to defend ourselves before you in this matter. If we are thrown into the blazing furnace, the God we serve is able to deliver us from it, and he will deliver us from your majesty's hand. But even if he does not, we want you to know, your majesty, that we will not serve your gods or worship the image of gold you have set up." You see, what these three guys did together was that they just demonstrated that no matter the situation we as Christ followers face, is that we must stand firm in our faith, guys. That no matter to the cost of the situation, which ultimately brings me to my first point of the night, it is important to stand with others that share similar convictions. Like I said, it's important as followers to be around other believers. But don't get me wrong, guys. Just because y'all share the same conviction, you can't rely on somebody else's convictions to get you through your foundations, guys. I want you to know that these three guys had three separate convictions that ultimately pointed each one of them to Jesus, ultimately allowed them to be able to stand firm together. As three, you know, it's tough when you're standing by yourself. But it's great when you have more people behind you. And it's great when you share the same convictions as those around you, because that emboldens you. You see here, the world constantly tells us to be quiet about our faith and not to force our faith onto anyone. But God calls us to do the opposite. He calls us to be bold in our faith. Go and share, because you know why? Because it shows who people are and it brings people to God. That's the important thing. That's what God wants from y'all, is for y'all to go out and spread his kingdom. That is what he wants. You see, another way that the world wants us to conform is when we, as Christ followers, mess up. You see, what we see is accountability as an act of love. They see it as an act of judgment. The world sees this as an act of judgment, where, how dare you judge me for messing up? How dare you? Don't bring me down. I'm telling you, guys, y'all, as believers of Jesus, when somebody messes up, we act and we say, "It's okay, because I love you, you know? It's okay that we get that you messed up. But, like, how can we fix it? How can we go about this to where you don't mess up and we're able to hold each other accountable?" Because that's what it's all about, right? We're not perfect, but when we hold each other accountable, it's an act of love. So the Bible tells us in Romans 12:2 to not to conform to the patterns of the world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing faith. But you see that the enemy doesn't want you to not conform to the world, because the world does not reflect God. And when you conform to the world, the enemy wins. And when we bow down to the world and when we conform, we don't get to show people who Jesus is. We don't get to demonstrate our faith to others. And you see again, so when the world does not reflect who our God is, the enemy wants us to conform to those ways. That's important, guys, is y'all must stand firm. But as we're going to see, when Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego stand strong in their faith, were willing to look different from others, God's power and greatness were put on display for everyone to see. So we're going to pick back up in verse 17. If we are thrown into the blazing furnace, the God we serve is able to deliver us from it, and he will deliver us from your majesty's hand. You see, this next verse is the most powerful statement out of it all. But even if he does not, we want you to know, your majesty, that we will not serve your gods or worship the image of gold you have set up. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were putting their full faith in God. They were trusting them that ultimately their lives didn't matter because they just believed in who God was and his power. I think it's even more powerful what they said if they weren't saved from the burning furnace, that they're willing to die for their faith. Which brings me to my next point. Having an eternal perspective of heaven will lead to security on earth. You see, what Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego had is called an eternal perspective, where no matter what they were facing, in the end, they were going to get to spend eternity with God. You see, Billy Graham, a famous minister, said it best. My home is in heaven. I'm just passing through this world. You see, what he meant was, when heaven is your home, you have nothing to lose but everything to gain. Simply this, when you put your faith truly with God, there's absolutely nothing that this world can do to you. You have this swagger to you when you have this eternal perspective, guys, that, oh, something bad happened? That's okay. God's got me. God's going to have you. He's there in your highs. He's there in your low. So like I said, you're going to have this swagger. You're going to be able to go through life when you have trials and tribulations to be, that's okay because God has me. When you fail that test, when you pray and say, Lord, please help me pass this test, and you don't, you know, that's okay because that doesn't make God any less. That doesn't make God this person that only shares the good things. That doesn't make God this vending machine of only good, right? That what you want and choose, guys. That's the important thing of having an eternal perspective, is that nothing here on earth is going to change who God is. And you get to spend eternity with him if you're a believer of his. That's the greatest gift of all, is this sense of getting to be in heaven, that what you face here is only a small amount to what you get to be living with Jesus, where you get to spend time in heaven where there's no hurt, there's no pain. You get to rejoice and get to be celebrating with Jesus. And that is just the greatest thing, guys. So as I begin to wrap up not only this message, but this entire series itself, we get to see that because of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, God's great and mighty power was put on full display for everyone to see. So you see here in verses 22 through 24, you're going to see where King Nebuchadnezzar kind of gets this sense of angriness because these guys weren't willing to bow down. I mean, he's the king. You're supposed to bow down. And you see, he says that his attitude towards them changed, that he ordered the furnace to be heated up 7 times hotter than usual and commanded some of the strongest soldiers in the world in his army to tie up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego and throw them into that blazing furnace. So these men, wearing their robes and trousers, were about to be thrown in. And you know what's the greatest thing? It's not the greatest thing, actually, but when they opened up that furnace, the soldiers themselves ended up being burnt because the flames were so hot. It wasn't the flames that you feel when you open the oven to check and make sure the cookies are open, ready. Like, it's not that feeling. Guys, this thing was hot that it instantly burnt them. So we're going to pick back up in 25. And he says, look, I see four men walking around in the fire, unbound and unharmed, and the fourth looks like the son of gods. Nebuchadnezzar then approached the opening of the blazing furnace and shouted, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, servants of the Most High God, come out. Come here. So Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came out of the fire, and the satraps, the prefects, the governors, and royal advisors crowded around them. They saw that the fire had not harmed their bodies, nor was a hair of their head singed. Their robes were not scorched, and there was no smell of fire on them. Then Nebuchadnezzar said, praise be to the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who has sent his angel and rescued his servants. They trusted him and defied the king's commands and were willing to give up their lives rather than serve any god except their own. You know, guys, we might not face real flames, but we all will still face the furnace. And when you see, when you're in that furnace, there's a fourth person with you, and that's who, and that's God. He's going to be there in that fire. What's miraculous is what they said was when they saw the fire that had not harmed their bodies, nor was a hair of their head singed, their robes were not scorched, and there was no smell of fire on them. Guys, we just learned that these soldiers that opened up the furnace burnt instantly. But these guys, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell into that furnace and didn't even get touched. How miraculous is that? How is that not able to show who God is? How is that not able to show the power that he has? Guys, when I tell you, when you're at your schools, that when you feel like this sense of not wanting to share your faith or not standing firm, and you get this little thought of maybe I should, I want y'all to start remembering who Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were, that they stand firm in their faith, that they were saved from a burning furnace. So what we just read brings me to my last point, that trusting God is always enough. You see, the power that delivered Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego from the flames is available to all of you. It's the same power that rose Christ from the dead. You just got to have a relationship with him. He doesn't call for anything else. He doesn't want you to do all these things. He doesn't want you to work your way towards heaven. He wants you to have a relationship with him. Because you want to know why he wants you to have a relationship with him? Because you have a conviction. Because you know who God is and you know how important it is. He wants you to have this eternal perspective that you can trust him in those moments. That when you have to stand firm, when you have to go against who the world is, that he's going to be there. That is, that what you face now is worth it when you get to heaven. And he wants you to know that he's enough, guys. That God is enough. That nothing else is going to be able to fill what God can. You see, when I had those anxiety, when I had those anxious thoughts, I was relying on people to fill a God-sized hole that could not be filled by anybody but God. Guys, I want y'all to know, because I lived it, your leaders have lived it. They understand where they were at one point versus where they're at now is completely different. You see, these leaders want y'all to understand that this relationship with God is powerful, that they want you to just experience who God is, that this power, let me be honest, we're not perfect. Just because we're followers of God, we're not perfect, guys. We still mess up. We still have flaws. We still have it, but that's okay because we aren't perfect. We can't be perfect. But Jesus coming down on this earth, living this perfect life, giving this ultimate sacrifice is enough. So God is enough, guys. And as I close tonight, and as the band begins to come back up, I just want to ask you this simple question, that is Jesus enough for you? Is Jesus enough to be willing to stand firm at your school? Is Jesus enough to be willing to look different from the world, even though the world calls us to conform? And if not, and you're not sure if Jesus is enough and not going all in, that's okay. Guys, talk to your leaders. Ask them, what made you want to follow God? Why is it important for us to spend a Sunday night getting to listen to God? So what's keeping you from going all in, guys? And I challenge you that if you're a little scared to jump in, that's okay, because Jesus is going to be jumping in with you. He's going to take that ledge. He's going to step with you. He's going to be there with y'all. Guys, when you go all in for Jesus, it's the best thing. And I can tell you that personally, because I'm still living it. I still get to live that life. So, guys, I just ask for y'all just to don't leave tonight without talking to a leader if you feel like you need to go all in. If you feel like you have these questions of who Jesus is, and if you feel like he's not enough, that's okay, because that's where we can see growth. So as we come out, we're just going to finish this night with some prayer, and we're going to finish with the band singing, and we're just going to proclaim and see the mighty name of Jesus and see what he's able to do. So let's pray. Dear God, I just want to thank you. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for just allowing us to just be yours, God, that we just get to be this not so perfect thing, God, but that you allow us to see and allow us to have a demonstration of what happens when we stand firm in this faith, that when we share convictions together, God, that we get to stand together to show your mighty name, God, and that when we have this eternal perspective, God, I just thank you for allowing us to know that whatever we face today and whatever we face, God, that you're just going to be there with me. And God, I just want to lastly ask that each of these students understand that Jesus is enough and that you're enough and that everything about you is just the most amazing thing. And in God's all great people said, amen.
Amen. It's like Jacob says, do you believe that he never leaves us? That he's always with us? So we're going to sing this song together. Let's look this up.
It's a grace when the heart is undefiled. Space between where I used to be and this reckoning, I know I will never be alone. There was another in the fire standing next to me. There was another in the waters, was holding back the seas. And should I ever need reminding of how I've been set free? that's where you'll be. I'll count the joy come every back, 'cause I know that's where you'll be. Amen. So Lord, again, just thank you for that simple truth, Father, that you have never left or forsaken us. God, no matter how deep we are and whatever our fire is, Father, we're just grateful, God, that you are in there with us. God, and that you've gone before us. God, and that the battle is already won. So, Father, would you teach us to trust you, God, and to trust your word and to trust your character. God, you are good to us when we don't deserve it, Father. So we love you and we thank you, and it's in your Son, in Jesus' name. And all God's people said, amen. Hey, you guys are dismissed.
It's always been